archer two. Cut down. Oh my goodness. Hello everyone, Thranxes is here, and welcome back to Conan Exiles, episode 113, and we finally got our combat update. In fact, we got a lot of things updated. So now we have this mega volcano area up here that used to actually be very cold, which is interesting, and then we also have this neat jungle area, which I very much kind of want to go explore and check out. But before we do that, I have been reading the comments, and I've decided a couple of things, and I've made some determinations, basically. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to take some more thralls and check out the combat update in the town nearby. After that, we're going to go ahead and finish building our tower, even if I have to do some time lapse. And then we're going to go start to explore some of the new stuff as we prepare for final release. So this episode will mostly be going over the update, but there will be a big building episode coming up where we finish the tower. I don't know if we'll get around to finishing this too, but my intention is to try to have a Conan episode out pretty much every day if possible until full release happens. So let's start covering some of the other new things that were introduced in this update. The feats were redone, quite different than Exile Epics. Epics? What's the... That's interesting. That's kind of interesting. So you have light, turban, armor value 6 versus these epics here, armor value 16. Oh, wow. That's pretty neat. But first, we're going to start with the attributes. So you can see we have these extra abilities floating around down here. If we go ahead and we add 1 point to grit, we'll get strong grip, so we use 10% less stamina while climbing. What I really want, though, is some strength. So let's start doing that. There we go, up to 10. And now we're getting bonus grit from our armor. That's also something else that's kind of neat. You can see here it says bonus grit, which is why it only cost 1 point for us to go from 9 to 10, because we already had 9 grit just off of our armor, which is really neat. Slice and dice would be good, but I fear we're also going to need vitality. Survival is pretty neat, but I don't think we really need that. Encumbrance we are going to need. So we can absolutely go up to 10 encumbrance. That gives us balance and counterbalance. I'll get it eventually. You deal extra melee damage while you're over encumbered, but you swing using less stamina when you're not over encumbered. So let's see where that puts us. We're still currently over encumbered because we're wearing all of this incredibly heavy armor. And in fact, we don't really have much of a vote. We have to put a lot into encumbrance to deal with this armor. So now you can see we're sure-footed. But we actually want to go all the way to Pack Mule. There we are. Increase your max carry weight by 10%. You have a chance to ignore armor and shield durability loss when hit. When you're over-encumbered, you can move at full speed. Ooh, interesting. Well, we've definitely got rid of the encumbrance. We're only lightly encumbered now. I think the next set of points should go to strength. In fact, I think strength should probably go all the way to 3, so that we have each light attack you do inflicts 10% more damage. We could go to heavy attacks, inflict 25% more damage, but I feel like we're going to need vitality. So let's start putting points in vitality. Let's see if we can get up to 3. All right, so that gives us more breath underwater, all temperature effects are diminished, and we gain passive health regeneration. I think the big benefit is going to be trying to min-max your points. Because here with 7 to go up halfway and then 8 to go up the rest of the way, we're not going to get any of these up to 4 or 5 without significant specialization. Although I also do see... I wonder if the level cap is increased. You know, I didn't see that in the patch notes, but... It could be. Raw and bloody, you don't have to cook raw meat to avoid poisoning. That's pretty cool. I think we should go up to 1 accuracy, and then agility would give us sprinting drains less stamina. Has a direct effect on armor as well. Let's do that. And then we could do survival, but that's not as important. 10% stamina per regeneration tick, or have falling damage is halved. No, we're going to go with... tempted to go with more strength. I'm going to mull that over. Let's see how this works. I'm anxious to get into some of the combat. So we're going to see how this works. And we have a whole new slew of things to set up. Hey, look, there's our wonderful thralls guarding our little camp here. Got a Cimmerian fighter there and a Dalinzia Snow Hunter. Oh, okay, so this one used to be a tier 4, and as it turns out, it is somebody named. And let's make sure you have your sword in your main hand. Do you not wear... Okay, I was like, come on now, don't play around with me, and you need your weapon in your hand. Main hand. Oh, and you have epic stuff. That's kind of neat. You don't. You have plain stuff. Okay, well, we're going to have to look at what it takes to make that epic stuff. But more than anything, it seems like our encumbrance is still really obnoxious with this armor on. Let's see how... Oh, that's our ghost troop. I don't see them. Okay, let's see if we can grab this person's attention here. Ooh! A little bit of a delay with the arrow. Oh, and it's kind of auto-released. Almost got that person's attention. Boom! Come on. Alright, let's do this. Ooh, nope. Come on. Nice. Okay, alright. Got a little crippled there. That wasn't so bad. I can see it's going to take me a little bit of time to get used to it. It already sort of popped me out into third-person mode when I did this. Is there a hotkey to... Yeah, let's just loot all. Oh, look how nice that is. Ah, we didn't bring an Ankh of Mitra. That's okay. We don't really need it just yet. I heard something. Let's see if we can pull this person. Okay, they're just going to kind of hang out there. They don't seem too involved. This person does. All right, come on. Blacksmith 3. Woo! And that one looks purple and shiny. Okay. That's kind of exciting. Let's... I don't have my truncheon and stuff ready to go. Of course I don't. Alright. Okay, so we got sundered a little bit. Ooh. Ooh. Okay, alright. Ooh. Doesn't seem to be doing too much damage, though. Ugh. Oh, there we go. Oof. Okay, alright, okay. Let's go back to the shield since I can't dodge. There you go. There you go. Okay, alright, I'm getting the hang of it. It's gonna take me a little bit of time. Can I sprint with the... Oh, I can. Thank goodness we can sprint with stuff in our hands once again. That was painful not being able to. It's gonna make things a little easier. Look, we got more epic stuff over here. Bonus vitality. Man. That's so cool. How can I tell if this is... It says flawless. High grade flawless. Did the other one say something like mid-grade, medium? It just has the little purple marks in the corners, but I don't know. Hey, that was pretty cool. We got a blacksmith 3 sort of right out the gate. Didn't do a ton of damage, or maybe it's just... No, we have significantly more health because we took the 3 ranks of vitality. That's pretty cool. So I should be able to tangle with quite a few people now. I don't necessarily want these things like this. There, let's go like that. And I don't know who this person is, but they seem to be unflinching. Oh, we have no ammo. That's no good. Here, unequip, and then put that there. There we go. Come on. It is some sort of archer. Fighter 2. Ooh, hacked down. Okay, these people aren't as strong as I remember them being. Archer 2. Cut down. Oh my goodness. So either the combat change made the difficulty a lot easier, or I don't know what. I feel like multiple values. What are you, fighter 1? Yeah, you can go down. Oh, this is fun. We're just going to carve people up now. There you go. Who else? Who else? Who are you? Blacksmith 1. Mm-hmm. Be careful. It can be dangerous out here. Wow, I haven't even really had to use much of my ambrosia. Okay, this is kind of neat. Well, I went from being unable to handle myself with just a handful of people to being a one-person wrecking crew. Fighter 1, you're done. Fighter 2. Fighter 3. Okay, that Fighter 3 might be worth taking. Ooh, what, who did I kill? I killed somebody. I might... Ooh, oh, whoa. That's a big, heavy weapon, actually. Hold on. Ooh. Yeah, okay, so this person does a little bit of damage. Okay. Ooh. Nope. Take another ambrosia. Okay. We need this person to join us. Son of a gun. Okay, I got in here all arrogant, thinking things were going to be easy.
Death will be as keen in loss as your life.
And now I've got to handle somebody who's... block. Oh, my shield broke! Oh. Kick! No! Ooh. Jump back. Oh, the kick doesn't even really stagger them. Oh, they've got good poise.
Ooh.
No! There you go. Ooh. Okay, alright, I have to say, so far I'm thinking the combat upgrade is really good. It definitely makes the combat more meaningful. I feel like before I just used to slash as much as possible, and I didn't notice a huge difference in between enemies. That was a significant difference from the scantily armored fighter 1s and even the fighter 2 that I killed in one hit that looked like they had armor. Granted, I wasn't trying to kill this one, but it's pretty good. Fighter 3. Let's go ahead and turn this on so we can start converting them. And I think what we'll do is we'll throw some of these things in here, maybe? Not really what's weighing us down, but... Broke that shield fast. Well, I'm tempted to go without a shield. Unfortunately, that was a freshly repaired shield, and if it's going to break that fast, I'm not going to spend the star metal on it. Let's see how we can do without a shield. We have heavy armor. I think we're going to take another ambrosia. I did just kind of walk in there and ask for it. So, So pay attention to their weapons and armor. It makes a big difference. I don't think we need all of these things, but I'm going to take them anyways. Now, what was this person over here? Arcanian Bearer. A Bearer. Bearer 2. I'll have to come back here and pay attention, see if I can get a Bearer 3. Figure out what they're good for. No, I don't. Well, I kind of do want that. I just want the glass, thanks. Oh, somebody else in here. Fighter 2. Cut down. Better be careful who you're talking to, yelling at like that. We're not going to tolerate that stuff now. We pretty much run this town, in case you haven't heard. Took out your best fighter. This is really neat. Okay, let's get our torch, because now our torch lasts longer too, and we can still sprint with things. Oh, and you can swipe a torch at people. That's... Okay, what do we got? Fighter 2. Cut down. This is good. This is good. I am very much liking the updates so far. We still have skill points we haven't assigned. Oh, let's see if our experience has changed any, actually. No, it has not. Okay, so it appears... I'm fairly certain that was the same number, so it appears the level cap is still the same for now. Even though we can get bonus attributes from our armor now. Oh, hello! Boom! Carpenter 1? No. No. We'll have no need for you where we're at. Ooh, a chest! Some grease orbs, sure, bone, I guess, why not? It's a little heavy, but it will do. This is really cool, though. So we're getting some thralls, and we're trying out the combat upgrade, or the combat update. It is an upgrade. It absolutely is an upgrade. It feels a lot more polished. The NPCs actually feel more polished. I feel like their movements are a little more believable. I haven't seen any standing on a campfire yet. Okay, that's the people playing chicken. Let's go over here. Oh, you heard me, huh? Why don't you have a seat? That's right. Yeah, sure, I'll take all that. That's right, stabbed with that ice sword. Not a good day. Not a good day for you, is it? Wow. You remember how difficult it was trying to come in here before? This is great. Oh, this kind of makes me wonder if we're going to be able at some point. Archer 2, not what I'm looking for. Stabbed in the back. What is this? Stygian spear? No, thanks. Could take the ale. No. We're not going to take the ale. Who's in here? A lot of people. I did notice the guards stayed dead while I was delivering thralls to the Wheel of Pain. That makes me feel good, too. Then at least they've fixed spawn issues. Alright, who's coming? Fighter 1? Oh, Tanner 2. Smelter 2. Armorer 2. A lot of less than desirable professions here. You guys are hitting me with your little mallets, but I don't really... Smelter 2. What did we get here? Oh. Got archers. Hold on. Any good archers? You're a fighter. You're Archer 1. Cut you down. More. Okay. All right. Let's take some ambrosia. Oh, I didn't check that archer first. Son of a gun. Back up. There you go. Very nice. Okay. It just says a corpse. It never identified what this person was, or... That's alright. It's alright. Got here. Fighter 1. lot of professions at 2, which... Oh! Another fighter 2. Put to the sword. Combat feels more visceral, like, more impactful. Felt like before I was kind of just, like, cutting through grass with my sword. Oh, I feel like I actually connect and... Oh, we've got a handful of archers. Okay, hold on. Archer 1 and Archer 1. And you're both going away. Encumbrance is getting up there. Oh. Okay. Can't have the torch out while climbing. That makes sense. I agree with that. Oh, we got coins! What? Silver coin. That's cool. That's really cool. Who might you be? You look like a archer... Oh, you're an archer too. Okay. Whoa. Panther trophy. No, we'll get our own. We're not going to take somebody else's panther trophy. That's kind of lame. Did we go inside this building and pull everybody out? I don't think we did. Hello? Who's here? Anyone? Well, perhaps we did pull everyone out. That's right, it was the armorer. Yeah, everybody was level 2, though. The tanner. That's okay, we're gonna keep sweeping through. Press E to interact. With what, I wonder? Is there a book or... Ah, there is a book. A confession. Oh. In the silence of my soul, I know that all of this is my fault. When my belly began to swell with Wraith's child, I was happy. He was happy. Even his family, who had always viewed me with suspicion, were happy. When the menfolk left on a week-long hunt, the women bathed me in lavender and rubbed scented oils into my belly. They burned beeswax candles and we talked into the night. When I lay down to sleep... Oh! Stand by. It says don't be reading our lore. Ooh, a fighter 3. Okay. Come on. Ooh. That two-handed hurts. You interrupted our lore reading. Come on now. Jump, jump, jump. Oh. I guess we're going to spawn back in the bed. And go back and get our stuff. Okay, so we went, we got all our stuff, we came back, and I'm trying to deposit this in the... Oh, there was a mammoth right here. Okay, they wandered off. Alright, good. That's good. So, but the difficult thing was I had to run in and try to get everything, and then the... Yeah, everybody was respawned. So I went ahead and switched the server over so that I won't lose my items anymore when I die, just to help with the time, because I'm trying to make as much progress as possible before we go into full release. That being said, I think we should absolutely go back over there and attempt to get... do we even have all of the... See, they're not giving me... You notice they're not giving me the armor anymore. The people of the village before used to give tremendous amounts of armor, and now they don't seem to, simply because I'm guessing they made the fights easier, so they said, well, we can't give out all the same armor if we're going to make the fights easier, I'm guessing. I'm not entirely sure. Look at this. You are nobody. We can go ahead and put you down. The arrow curves up a good bit. There we go. Boom. Come on, try again. Out of ammo. I find that hard to believe. There we go. How am I... Oh, okay. All right. Then this is how we're going to do it. Archer 1. That's right. Got some arrows sticking in me. It's alright. We're gonna run past you. Hey! You don't look like anybody important. Or you. Okay, so some people respawned, but there are still a lot of bodies here. Fighter 1, Smelter 2, Armorer 1, Archer 1. Okay? Ooh, okay, we're getting staggered a bunch. Let's cut through here. Ooh. Come on. Okay, that's a little weird. I can't make contact with this person. Hitbox was a little obscured or something. I'm not sure what caused that. Let's take some ambrosia. See if we can just put you down like that. Thank you. Ooh, a gold coin. Give me that. Give me all of this stuff. We'll sort it out later. You're just an archer one. That lunge feels as good as it looks. I'm just letting you know. Hello. Yes. My tanners. Tanner 1. Tanner 3. Excellent. Boom. Come on. Oh, okay. Okay, first of all, you can take a seat right now. Come on. Okay, hold on. So we knocked out the Tanner 1. Fighter 2, Fighter 1. Okay. I have to try a little harder now because we don't have the shield. Come on, stop doing the flourish. Just club them. Oh. Hold on. Boy, groups are a little more challenging than one-on-one, though. Okay. Fighter 1 should be going down soon. Now we're getting the Tanner 3. Come on. There you go. Double hit them like that. Okay. Good. And then we'll take a Tanner back with us. This is interesting. It felt really deceptively easy at first, but really the ease comes from just having to fight one person at a time, because the biggest difference is now that multiple people will stagger you multiple times. There's no sort of, like, invulnerability window where you were just hit and you can't be re-staggered, which, I mean, in a way, it sort of reminds me of a Dark Souls sort of feel, and that every hit from the enemy needs to be considered, and we don't have a blacksmith's table up yet, do we? Did we put one down here? Felt like this was the plan, to put one here in the corner, but we didn't. So instead we're storing a bunch of materials here. Wow, we actually got a lot of steel bars doing this. And some dyes. Hyena pelt. Okay, so we've gotten some cool things. To be quite sure, we've gotten some neat things. No extra armor sets, though, so it looks like we're going to be making our own armor sets for our thralls. And I'm okay with that because... we're going to have to look into what it takes to make epic suits of armor. Now, I am going to go ahead and commit and say that the next episode we do after this one, which... to be fair, I don't want to get ahead of myself. I was going to do a very building-heavy episode, an episode focused on getting work on the tower done. But with the combat update dropping, it just felt wrong to build. It's like, come on, we've got to mix it up. Nope, no, I missed. There we go. Cut down. What are you? Archer 1. And you? You don't want to tell me. I will assume you are also an Archer 1. Although, to be fair, I don't know. You could have been anybody. If Okay, I want to see a part of the camp we haven't seen yet. Come on. Archer 1. Thank you. Goodbye. How about Archer 2? Ooh, I missed. No, climb the wall. Oh, that was close. We're wearing heavy armor too. Okay, all right. We're going back down. Let's try this path over here. Now, the purge has been added to the game as well, and that's another thing we're going to do. Once we get our tower built up, we're going to go ahead and trigger the purge, but we're going to have to get some thralls, get the tower built up, and then try to figure out how to make some of this better gear as well. Now, the purge won't happen in its current state because I'm... Oh, Sumerian Berserker. What? I'm going to go out on a limb and say you're probably pretty valuable. Oh, the damage. Yep. Okay, we're getting hurt. We'll let the stamina come back, please. Crippled and sundered. Oh my goodness! Okay, so the Berserker's kind of serious. We don't have a shield. We could get another one, but the shield doesn't seem to last very long. Alright, okay, we're just going to regenerate our health some more so we can get some more hits on you. Ooh! Okay, alright. Okay. Alright. It's a lot about stamina management and dodging. No, back up! The Berserker, not to be trifled with. No, this is good. This is interesting because it was a one-on-one fight, but it was so difficult to try and... What? Okay, apparently this bed is in a bad spot, I'm thinking. Let's see if we can climb out. Okay, we'll have to move that bed. Duly noted. So we've tried out, we've previewed the combat upgrade, and we looked at the attributes, and we've seen some of the differences. I think this is the point at which I'm going to wrap up the episode. But know that next episode there's going to be a good bit of work done in between this episode and next episode, and we should be at a point where we're ready to finish building the tower. Even if I have to do something with time lapse, I'm not sure yet. But we're going to get the tower complete, then we're going to fill it with thralls, then we're going to do the purge, then we're going to go to the jungle. As I said, I'm going to be trying to put out a Conan episode every single day. It's going to be tough, but I think we can do it. So this has been Conan Exiles episode 113, as we sampled combat in the Mounds of the Dead post-combat update. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you've had a good time watching. As always, I've had a good time playing. So be sure and come back next time as we commence building the tower, hopefully to completion. Maybe not decoration, but at least to completion. But until next time, take care.